Hi, welcome to Savi's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. In this video, I'm showing drafting a basic body block on CAD. Many of us may not be using CAD, and those using would already know how to use the tools. I'm sharing this video only because it's interesting to know, and it's always good to keep ourselves updated. There are different softwares. The one I'm using here is Gemini. So let's see how this works. Now this is the screen for Gemini Pattern Designer. You see the menu here and there are toolbars. The first toolbar has some standard tools like new file, file open, save, undo, redo, zoom, etc. And the second toolbar changes as per the selection you make in this main tool. Now when you place the mouse pointer on one of the tools, it will show the name of the tool. Now this is called the piece mode. Second is the shape mode, draw mode, garment mode. These are the four main tools which we'll be using today. There are other tools like grading, measure mode, made to measure, which we'll not be using today. Now, as per the selection you make here, this toolbar changes. So currently it's in piece mode. I'll click on shape mode and you see the tools here changes. Draw mode gives you the option to draw different shapes, and garment mode will allow you to edit the seam allowance, notches, technical lines, pleats, darts, etc. Even here, when you place the mouse pointer on a tool, it shows you the name of the tool as to what it does. So this shows us edit seam allowance. So as we draft the pattern, we'll see some of the tools, how they are used to draft the pattern. Now first, for drafting a pattern, you need to draw a rectangle on the screen. For that, you need to click on draw mode and select the second option, that is draw rectangle. Now there are different shapes like three lines, ellipse, circle, etc. So now we'll only see the rectangle. Now you see the mouse pointer has changed. Just click on the screen and drag and click again. Now on the right hand side, it's asking for the dimensions. In the first row, you can type the length of the garment. I'm going as per the measurement chart here. This is for a small size, and the measurements given here are half pattern measurements. That is, for example, quarter chest round, that is inclusive of ease. And the full length shows us 36. So here I'll mention the length of the garment, that is 36 inches. Now inches is already showing here. If you want to change it to centimeters, you can change it in the settings. Once you enter the measurement, press on enter on your keyboard. Now in the second row, you can give the measurement of your quarter chest round, quarter bust round, waist round or hip round. I will give the quarter chest round measurement, that is 8.50. Enter and validate. So we have created a rectangle. Now within the piece mode, that is the first option, you can click on a pattern and move it anywhere on the screen. And also in the piece mode, you can give a name to the pattern. For example, if we are doing the back first, on the right hand side it says piece properties and piece name. Click on that and I'll type as back and the size, that is 32. Enter. So you see the name has come here. Let's zoom it. To zoom, you can click on this zoom option or you can scroll your mouse and zoom. So it shows the name here. Now also, if you want to see the measurements of this rectangle, you can click on show height distance on piece. So you see the measurements has come here. 36 is the length we had given and 8.50 the height. So we'll make this pattern similar to how we do the manual pattern. The right hand side will keep it as the hem of the dress and the left hand side the shoulder. Click on shape mode and click on this point, and on the right hand side I'll set it as the origin. All the markings will be measured from this point. Now first we'll mark the neck width and the half shoulder measurement. So I click on this point and I click on this option here, create a new point at a given distance, and I'll keep the neck width as 2.50. So I just type 2.5 and enter. So I've got a new point here, 2.5 inches away from the original point. Now one more thing to notice, from any point the vertical, that is up or down, is called the y-axis, and the horizontal or side to side is called the x-axis. And any new point you add clockwise, you need to give a positive number, and any new point you want to add anti-clockwise, you need to give a negative number. That is, now I'll mark the neck depth, that is back and front. So again I click on this point, I click on the option here, create new point. Now I'll give a negative number because we are marking the points anti-clockwise. So back neck depth is 1 inch, so I type as minus 1. Now in the same time you can create multiple points. I'll also create a point for the front neck depth. So I give a space and type as minus 6, that is the front neck, and enter. So you got 2 points here, at 1 inch, that is for back neck, and at 6 inches, that is for front neck. Now again from this point I do another marking, that is half shoulder measurement. Now when you place the mouse pointer for long on a line, it changes. So again if you place the mouse pointer, the dotted lines go off. So again I create a new point, and here on the right hand side I type the half shoulder measurement, that is 6.75. enter. So I've got my shoulder measurement. Here on this line I'll mark the waist point and the hip length. So the waist point shows us 13.5 and hip length is 21. To get a point anywhere on this line, you can just double click, or you can click on shape mode and click on this option, add point. So I click on this line, I add point. So I've got the point. Now I want this point 13.5 inches down from this original point. So I click on this point. All the point properties will show here. It's showing me it is 14.89 inches down. What I want is 13.5. So I change this, 13.5, enter. See, this has moved. Now I'll double click and create another point, that is for hip length, and click on that point and check the distance. It shows 20.37. I want it at 21 inches. So I change it. Enter. Now this is the half shoulder measurement. I want it 1 inch down because of the shoulder slope. So I click on that point, and here on the right hand side there is this option, move from current X and Y. So I want it to move in this way, that is X axis. So I mention here 1 and enter. So I've got my shoulder slope. Now I'll create another point here, that is the half arm round measurement. I'll just create a point first and then measure. So I double click and create a point. Now I'll keep this as the origin. So I'll click on this point and set as origin. Now the half arm round measurement is 5 inches. So I want this new point 5 inch down from this point. So I click on this and I check here. So it shows 6.4. I make it 5. Enter. Now I do not want this point. I want to remove this because I've got my arm round point here. I double click on this to remove, or I click on this point and click on this tool here, delete point. So that point is deleted. Now to draw the armhole curve, I convert this straight line to a curve by clicking on the option here, turn to curve. So you see you've got two handles here. You can click and drag them and create the appropriate shape. So we have got all the vertical measurements. Now the round measurements. Again, I'll set this as the origin. Now this is the waist point. The quarter waist round measurement here is 7.25. If I click on this waist point and see here, waist round shows as 8.50. I'll change it to 7.25. Enter. And the hip round needs to be 9.25 as per the measurement chart here. If I click on that point, and on the right hand side it shows as 8.50, and I change it to 9.25. enter. Similarly, I'll change this hem also to same as the hip round measurement. Now we need to smoothen this curve, so we'll change this line to a curve by clicking on turn to curve, and also this line. And to smoothen this point, we'll click on the point and click on 180 degree, and this point as well. Now you can move these handles and slightly make any changes. This looks fine. Now suppose if you want to give a flare here, you can click on this point, and as I explained earlier, to move it vertically you need to change in the dy here. So for example, if I want to add 2 inches to the flare, I can type 2 here and enter. You see it's added 2 inches there. Or if you do not want this change, you can undo what you have done by clicking on undo option here. Now suppose you want to give a slight curve at the hem, click on this point and you can bring it up by 1 inch. So I'll type as minus 1 because now we are marking anti-clockwise from the point. So I'll type as minus 1, enter. Then click on this line and turn to curve. Click on this point and click on this option here to change it to 90 degree. Once you set any point at 90 degree, you see you cannot move the handle in this way. You can only move it this way because this line will be 90 degree to this line. And draw a smooth curve. Okay, now coming to the neckline. This is the neck width point and this is the neck depth for the back. Now we don't need this point here. So you can just double click and remove, or you can click on the point and click on this option, delete point, and turn this line to a curve. And again, here it has to be a 90 degree angle so that you get a smooth neckline. So we click on that point and click on 90 degree and reshape to a smooth curve. Now if you need to increase the armhole, you can easily do it by clicking on this point and use the arrow key on your keyboard to move it. For example, I'm using the right arrow key. And if you want it to move very slightly, then press the control key on your keyboard and then press the arrow. So it will move just a little each time you press the arrow. So once the back is done, to draft the front, what you can do is click on piece mode, click on the first option, copy, and then click on the second option, paste. Or on your keyboard, you can do Ctrl C and Ctrl V. So you've got a exact same copy of the back. So keep the original aside. You can see the name here. This is the copy of the back. Click and drag it down. Now we'll change this to front. First we'll change the name. So we are in piece mode. On the right hand side, instead of back, we'll type as front. Enter. So the name has changed. Now the only changes we'll make is to the armhole and the neckline. Now to zoom only this piece, I click on the zoom option here. That is, I click on the pattern first and click on zoom. Okay, now for front, this is the neck width and this is the neck depth. I don't want this point, so I can double click and delete. Now why it's not deleting? Because I am in piece mode. I need to click on shape mode before doing that. Now it's deleted. Now it's already curved. You can change the shape. You can easily do different shapes, or you can add a point in between. Keep the first part straight, that is, click on the first part and click on turn to line. Or you can move this higher. And do a little deeper curve for the armhole. That is, I'll bring it in a little. Now you can go to piece mode, click on any point and drag it and place it on the back to see if everything matches. So the length is same, the shoulders match. Armhole is correct, that is, front is deeper than the back. So if everything is fine, then this is done. We can go ahead with the sleeves. Now when you place the mouse pointer on a point for long, it creates these arrows, which gives you some options here on the right hand side, which we'll not see in this video. To remove those arrows, you just have to place the mouse pointer again on that same point for some time and it's removed. Now we'll draft the sleeves, for which I will again go to draw mode. Click on rectangle, create a rectangle. Length I'll give as 14 inches for long sleeves. And here I'll give 5.75. That is half arm round plus ease. Enter. This can be later altered if needed. Validate. I'll click on piece mode and zoom this. I'll remove the cartridge. Now the left hand side will keep it as the sleeve open, and this is the sleeve crown. I'll set this point as the origin Before that, let me click on shape mode. So I'll click this and set as origin. I'll mark the cap height at 3.5 inches. So I'll bring this down by 3.5. Click on this point. Here, I will type as minus 3.5. Minus because we are coming anti-clockwise. I'm typing it here under dx because this is the x-axis. And if it is vertical, it will be y. So minus 3.5. Okay, sleeve open will keep it as 4.5 inches. So I'll click on this point. It shows me what is the width. So this was the point of origin. From here, the distance is 5.75 and I want it 4.5. So I type 4.5. Okay, now we'll chain this line to a curve. Now I'll chain this point to 90 degrees. Now once you set the point to 90 degree, you cannot bring this handle to any other angle. It can only move forward or backward. I'm not able to move it sideways. Now if you don't want point to be 90 degree, you can click on that point and click on this option here, set free angle. So it will set this point free. Now I'll be able to move it in any direction. So again, if I want it 90 degree, I click on the point and click on 90. And using this shape the curve. You can also see the measurement by clicking on this option. You can increase it slightly or you can bring the cap height down if you want to increase the measurement to match with the body armhole. Now also, if we want to make the sleeve slim fit, we can curve this line, click on curve, and you can slightly drag it inside. Now what we have done is the back sleeves. So once you are happy with this, go to piece mode, copy, paste, or Ctrl C and Ctrl V on your keyboard. So you get a copy of this. Now I'll keep this aside. Now we'll chain this to front. So to do that, you have learnt in manual pattern making, the front curve is slightly deeper. So we click on this. Before doing the changes, what I'll do is, I'll enable this option, that is create ghost. What this does is, it will show the original line also as you make the changes. So you know what changes you're making. Now I'll click on shape mode and click on this. I'll keep this as it is, only this part I'll change. I'll make the curve deeper. This is what create ghost means. The original line still shows, so you know what exact changes you're making. So this is the front. Now I'll flip this. For that I'll go to piece mode. There's an option here to flip, vertical flip, horizontal flip. We are doing the vertical flip. I click on this and so you see it has flipped. Now I'll hold this point and bring it to the back. These are magnetic points. As you get it closer to another point, it will attract and it's aligned. Now if I try to move the sleeves, you see only one part is moving. We want both to move together. So what I'll do is, I'll select this and click on join pieces. Now you see this is one single piece. Now when I click and drag, it moves as one piece. So that's all in this class. There are a lot many interesting tools and there's a lot to learn in this, which we'll see in the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon in the next class. Until then, happy sewing.